and a look at our Luther Family Ford Skycam shows a few flurries here and there, but by and large, things are pretty quiet, a little on the breezy side for our Wednesday evening, but I expect things to stay quiet, especially as those lingering snow showers or flurries do wrap themselves up as we go through the rest of this evening. Current temperatures at Hector International, 21 degrees with that 9-degree wind chill. Notice the wind north-northwest at 12 miles per hour. So that's bringing in some drier air. So notice the dew point. The dew point is the measure of moisture in the air. I expect that to actually fall as we go through the night because we are seeing that dry air moving in from the north and west. So as those dew point temperatures fall, it's easier for an atmosphere to cool down a drier air. So with a lower dew point, I expect temperatures to again be in the upper single digits to lower teens waking up tomorrow morning. But the bitter cold we had has finally pushed off over the Great Lakes region off toward a New York City area. So we are starting to see that warmer air punch its way in, or at least try to. And so I do expect this warmer air that right now is over the Rockies to move in to round out the work. We can also stick around into the weekend as well. So things are not looking too bad in the temperature department moving forward in that 7-day planner, which I'll talk about in just a second. But temperatures right now, we're seeing those low teens already. There's some clear sky, some very dry air up here in the Devil's Lake Basin. So that's where we're more likely to see those upper single digits, maybe even middle single digits in the cooler spots in the Devil's Lake area. But we're still holding on to, in Aberdeen, 27 degrees, 23 in Sisseton and Wahpeton, 20 for our friends in Bedette, then upper teens for the rest of our Minnesota neighborhoods. And the wind chill, again, where the temperature is the coldest, the air is the driest, wind is a little bit more busy. 0-degree wind chill there in Devil's Lake, a 4-degree wind chill at this hour in Grand Forks. So you do see the drier I'm talking about right there just outside of Winnipeg. So a lot of clear sky, and that's moving into the Devil's Lake area, which is also helping to cool their temperatures down faster. Still some clouds and a few showers holding on up and down the I-29 corridor just south and west of Grand Forks. But you see that kind of the darker blues are becoming less and less. So as the air dries out, we're seeing less and less of these flurries actually making it to the ground. So again, I do expect conditions to improve as we head through the evening. And the hour by hour shows how that dry air punches in and those clear sky works. And even by 10:10 this evening, seeing already some upper single digits in our northwestern neighborhoods. Wake up tomorrow morning again with that clear sky and dry air around. Upper single digits to low teens expected for that bus stop on your Thursday morning. Do expect some clouds to increase though through the afternoon hours. Maybe a spotty snow shower here or there, but notice the winds now more out of the west and southwest. So we're going to start to see some warmer air moving in for the day Thursday, which will make things feel a lot better. Even with a bit of a breeze out there on Thursday, we'll be about 5 to 10 degrees warmer for our Thursday. And again, can't rule out some spotty snow showers, but not looking at anything too impactful for our Thursday. Temperatures there top out, you see, in the middle 30s there with the winds from the southwest at 12 southwest between 10 and 20 miles per hour, excuse me, warming those temperatures up, bringing some warmer air in, some more mild air in. And notice those temperatures only get to the 30-degree mark as we head toward tomorrow night. But for your hometown forecast, tomorrow expecting upper 20s there in Minnesota where the clouds are a bit more persistent. Middle 30s to the south where we see some sun. Could even see a low 40 in the lucky spots in our southern neighborhoods. A beautiful shot of the sunshine in Oaks with that train going on a fresh snowfall there in Oaks. Thanks, Vincent, for sending that into us. And we stay in the mid-30s for the rest of the work week. The weekend, Andrew and Mike, in the 40s, maybe a spotty shower here or there for the weekend, but the tailgaters on Saturday, looks like those showers start after tailgate time on Saturday.
That sounds good. Thank you.
It does, yeah. Up next on Valley News Live, it's